Experiment number 5 deals with separations and analysis. We'll look at 3 different techniques that are used to separate chemical compounds. The first is paper chromatography. Paper that we use in paper chromatography is a little thicker, a little more absorbent than ordinary paper. And in this case, we'll be separating ions, iron, cobalt, and copper ions. And the technique involves taking a piece of paper. We've got a dotted line toward the bottom of the paper. And at these X's, we'll spot solutions of these particular ions. Then we take the paper, put it in a solvent, and the solvent will climb the paper. And as it does so, it carries the ions with it. Depending upon their solubility in the solvent, and the affinity that they have for the paper. So if a compound has a strong affinity for the paper, it won't migrate very far. If it has more or less affinity for the paper and is more soluble in the moving mobile phase, it'll travel further up the paper. After the solvent reaches near the top of the paper, we take the paper out of the container, let it dry, and then spray it, in this case, with ammonia. And ammonia reacts with these 3 ions to give colored complexes so that we can see where these ions have migrated. So it's a very useful technique. It's fun to carry out. It's very visual. You can see exactly where the ions have migrated. And if we also spotted an unknown that maybe would contain 1, 2, or 3 of these ions, you can use comparative distances of migration to identify the components in the unknown. The very first thing you would see is how many components are in the unknown by the number of spots. And the second thing you could do was to compare their RF values. That's the distance that the compound has traveled divided by the distance that the solvent has traveled. And if the unknown has this particular ion, it'll migrate the same distance. Very, very useful technique and fun to carry out. In the second part of this experiment, we'll use sublimation to separate 2 chemical compounds, calcium carbonate and ammonium chloride. Sublimation, you'll recall, is when a solid goes directly into a gaseous state without passing through the liquid stage. Freeze-dried foods are an example where sublimation has been used in processing them. They freeze the foods and then put the foods under a vacuum, and the ice goes directly into the gaseous state. They pump off the water vapor, leaving behind the solid foods. And it's a way of keeping the structural material intact, whether it's bread or whatever the freeze-dried food is. Another example, in the old days, they used to hang out clothes in the wintertime on a line, and the clothes would immediately freeze because if the day was a very cold day. But later on, if you looked out, maybe the clothes were flapping in the wind because the ice had gone directly into the gaseous state as the clothes dried without ever passing through the liquid state. Well, in this experiment, here's a beaker. Down at the bottom of the beaker, calcium carbonate and ammonium chloride. Up at the top, we've got some sort of surface now that's a little cooler, and we'll apply heat to this mixture. The solids go into the gaseous state, or one of the solids does, and then it deposits on the bottom of the surface up here in crystalline form. Or in other words, it sublimes. Sublimes and then deposits as a solid on the cooler surface. And what you'll do is test this solid and the original 2 solids and decide what you've got up here. You use hydrochloric acid to carry out this test. And in this case, you'll want to watch for the evolution of gas. Where do you get bubbles forming? Remember that gas formation is one of the three observations that we use in chemistry to decide if a chemical process is occurring. In part C, we'll look at using solubility to separate solids. In this experiment, you've got two compounds, calcium carbonate and copper sulfate. One of these is soluble in water, one is very insoluble in water. So if we add water to this mixture and then filter it, up here in the top of the filter, the insoluble solid will collect. The liquid that passes through the filter is called the filtrate, and it contains the water-soluble substance. And you'll have two chemical tests that you use now to see if you can identify this material and the insoluble solid. One of these tests will involve a color change. One of them will involve a gas evolution.